Good evening once again from the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin. For tonight's WIAA matchup between the visiting Ishwaubenon Jaguars and your DePere Voyagers.
Hey, Kurt, we only got one person tuned in right now, so do you want to wait a little bit before we go through?
Hey, he's listening.
All right.
I guarantee that's Coach.
Yeah,
I'm betting that's Coach Borsa. The DePere Voyagers coming into this game off of a rough matchup last Saturday night against the Bayport Pirates, but they're going to take on another very good Ishwaubenon Jaguar team. The Ishwaubenon Jaguars in gray and green off to our right. The DePere Voyagers in their home whites. My name is Kurt Folt. I'll be bringing you the play-by-play. You heard him already. They don't call him the best man in the color man in the WIA for nothing, folks.
Thank
he
you,
keeps
Kurt.
Me on my toes. Brett Thom.
Appreciate that, Kurt. Well, we only got five people that heard those accolades, so I'm going to have you tell everybody what a good job I've been doing again here in about 10, 15 minutes.
And we'll go with that, Brett. But
all
you
right.
know what? Just by us talking, now we're up to 11.
That, right.
And we started at 1 like 30 seconds ago. I mean, when we turn this stuff on, people flock to our stuff here. So welcome again to the DePere Ice Arena for tonight's WIAA matchup. Brett, Voyagers coming off a tough loss last Saturday night to the Bayport Pirates. Really didn't play a great game, I'll just put it that way.
Yeah, I mean, we could pass blame around all night for how that game went. There's plenty of it to be shared. There wasn't any one aspect of the game that was up to the task and at fault for the result that occurred last week.
No, absolutely not. And I'm sure head coach John Koppel is looking for a better outcome. I have to do this real quick. We'd be remiss if we can get a picture on the young lady that is walking by. She'll have her back to us. Hey, Christina Koppel. Christina. Well, sorry about that yelling, folks, but we got to say happy birthday to Christina Koppel. Her birthday was yesterday. So happy birthday to Christina. It's good to see her out moving around. I know she's got a little bit of a bad foot or knee or something. But we got to give a shout out.
Is age catching up to her?
No. It was a little bit of an accident. I think she broke a bone in her foot, actually. But got to give a shout out here. We do have some fans coming into the ice rink itself, not in by the ice itself, but we'll have some fans here tonight. You know what? And that's a good thing. It's a great thing, and hopefully we'll have everybody here tonight. Not sure how many are here just yet. It's a little tough to see to the far end of the rink. But
yeah, we certainly don't have as many viewers tuned in, and that is because we do have more parents able to at least watch from a distance tonight rather than have to listen to us. But like you mentioned, they are quarantined to the lobby right now. They're not able to get back down into the stands just yet.
And once again, you saw her walk by again. Happy birthday, Christina Koppel. So we got to give a shout out here too. Welcome back to number 9 for the Voyagers, Tanner Newton. After a little bit of a hiatus, his family went through a little bit of an illness spell there that he had to sit out, even though he never tested positive.
All those quarantining rules that you got to follow and adhere to. So, and that's the issue that we're having with our not quarantining, but all the rules that we're in the situation of having to follow right now, and not being able to have the parents actually in the stands, in the rink, which we're the only one in the area, in the FRCC, that is being forced to do this, and I guess we'll stop there before I dig a hole deeper than it needs
probably,
to be.
Probably good. And, you know, you're digging your way out, and I dig myself in on the officials sometimes. So, once again, we're gonna take a quick break here. There's about 7 minutes left in the warm-ups. We're going to take a quick break, leave you to sounds of the rink here. And we'll, when we come back, we'll have the starting, we're going to take it down to the PA, the starting lineups, and the national anthem, and then the puck drop. For Brett Thom, I'm Kurt Foth. Welcome to the game. And we'll get back with you shortly from the DePere Ice Arena in DePere, Wisconsin.
Good evening, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to the varsity game here tonight with the Pure Voyagers versus the Ashwaubenon Jaguars. We're just getting ready for team announcements here and the national anthem, and we'll be back and get going.
Good evening once again from the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin for tonight's WIAA varsity matchup between the visiting Ashwaubenon Jaguars and your DePere Voyagers. Moments away from getting started here, head coach John Koppel coming out with his line of Mercatoris and Koppel at wings. Welcome back Tanner Newton to center and Ian Markison and Tommy Vandalist on the defensive end. Henry Allen, the junior goaltender in net. My name is Kurt Folth. Brett, welcome.
Thank you, Kurt.
We're moments away from getting started here as the teams are making their final preparations. to get started. Is Schwabenon and DePeer played here about a month and a half ago?
Yeah, I want to say it was like December 11th or the 5th or somewhere back in there, Kurt. Schwabenon jumped out to a quick 2-0 lead in the first period during that game, and the Voyagers fought back, tied it up, put it into overtime, and won it in overtime. I think that was our first, or was that our second overtime game?
It was the second in a row, actually, because we learned the week prior that it was 3-on-3.
Which I believe was incorrect, right? They're not doing that anymore?
Have no idea. We haven't been to overtime since then.
Yeah, we won't worry about it.
But we're close and ready for faceoff, and here we go, folks. As Schwabenon gains control early, Vandlis will pick it up in his own zone. Mercatoris will keep it outside the Voyager zone. Vandlis will pick it up back in the near corner, out to Mercatoris. Mercatoris cross ice, just misses Koppel. And the Jaguars will send it back in. Markison hits a referee, trying to get the puck out of the zone. Jaguars will hang on to it inside the Voyager zone. Markison back in the far corner. 16:29 left here, just getting started in the first period. Welcome to everybody who's watching the game online. And it looks like Grady Koppel got nicked up a little bit. Nice poke check there by Ian Markison. And the Voyagers are going to come down the opposite way with Burkholz.
Buchamovic on the pressure there.
Buchamovic, thank you.
Yep.
Drew a blank there for a second. Geminani and Foth back on defense right now. Voyagers, Charlie Eggers in the far corner. Gets it back to Geminani. He gets a shot blocked. The Jaguars will chip it all the way down. Geminani will pick up. Jaguars are going to change. Charlie Eggers quickly off the boards. Borseth can't control. And that gets sent back into the Voyager zone. Foth back to pick it up. Back around. Back behind the net. He'll take. Stop. Circles back around. Borseth trying to chip around. And a Schwabenon player. Geminani will pick it back up and send it to Buchamovic. Jaguars control once again. Foth will pick it up back behind the Voyager net and come away with it down the far side. He'll chip it all the way out. Icing is waved off as a Schwabenon player. Tip that. Bartelt trying to gain control. Chips it out front. Here comes a Schwabenon back the other way. Koppel, nice poke on that shot, keeping it away from his goaltender. Thom rides a player off. As Schwabenon comes back in, they'll send it back all the way back to Vandlis. Vandlis chips it out to Roskam. Roskam will have a head of steam. He gets taken off the puck. And Koppel on the chase. Koppel, Bartelt. Bartelt will keep it in the zone. Koppel takes it away from one. Can't get it back on a stick on the other one. Tanner Newton just offsides.
I would say barely offsides. That one could have gone the other way too, I think, Kurt.
14:18 left here in the first. No score. And actually a good paced game here so far. Really, I don't know that there's been a shot yet.
Yeah, I'm encouraged by the start. We talked a little bit before the game. There weren't many people tuned in then, but we had a rough game last week. The boys look like they're ready to go tonight, and that's good to see.
Newton, Koppel, and Mercatoris on offense right now. Foth and Markison back on defense. Jaguars right out in front. Nice job by Tanner Newton, poke checking it away. Just couldn't get anyone out front. That goes back to Markison. Markison shot wide, tried to redirect it by Koppel. Couldn't get it done. And that comes back out to center ice. Nice job by Johnny Mercatoris. Taking and knocking that puck down so it didn't get back behind. Newton takes a player off. D-to-D pass over to Foth. Foth off the near boards. Sends it back in deep. The Voyagers are going to change. And the Jaguars will come out down the far side of the ice. Jaguars gain entry. Geminani on the far side. Charlie Eggers, big hit, and he'll come away with a puck. Wagner will pick it up on the near boards. Chips around one. That goes all the way back to the Jaguars' D-to-D pass. And Geminani will keep it out of the Voyager zone. Burkholz picks it up over to Wagner. Wagner will chip it down in deep. The Voyagers will chase. Defense changes for the Voyagers. That comes all the way back out to Thomet, center ice, over to Vandalis. Vandalis chips it back in, and the Voyagers will chase one more time with Burkholz. Here comes the Jaguars back the opposite way. Gain entry, shot, glove save, and Henry Allen will hang on. 12:45 left here in the first. No score in the game. And again, pace is pretty good here right now, Brett.
Yeah, I like it, and I like that it's been in the Ashwaubenon zone for the majority so far. So keep breaking this puck out, controlling it, making some good passes here. Keep this pace up.
Voyagers trying to break it out the far side. Can't. Here comes the Jaguars back the other way. Stops, crosses. Nice poke check there by Bartelt. Shot from the point. Glove saved by Allen.
Nice job, Henry.
Holding on again, and we'll have a faceoff coming to the stick side of Allen with 12:28. Forgot to mention, folks, the DePere Voyagers would like to thank all of their sponsors, including Camera Corner, Heartland Pizza, Chicago Street Pub and Grill, Green Bay Family Dental and DNS Machine Service. We thank all of our sponsors. Vandalis will control, tries to get it to Thom. Little miss on the pass. Tanner Newton will pick it up, and they'll come out the near side. Mercatoris can't control. Mercatoris keeps it out by the blue line. They do get it out of the zone. Tanner Newton will drop it back for Vandalis, and the Voyagers will try and break it out again. Coming out the near side, Mercatoris, cross-ice pass. The Voyagers were changing a defenseman right there. Unfortunately, little misplay by the Jaguar defenseman, and they'll take it all the way back in, back behind their own net, and try and break it out again. Foth will pick it up at center ice. Off the near boards, Ashwaubenon will keep it out, and they'll send it back in. Foth will have to pick it up with 11:35 left here in the first period. Gets around one defenseman. Newton tries to poke check it away. Foth will have to go back and pick it up again. Tries to dig around. He gets a stick knocked out of his hands. He's fighting through it with no stick. Ashwaubenon picks it up back behind the Voyager net. Koppel circling, drops it back for their defense. Shot from the point, wide. Ashwaubenon will gain the rebound. Back behind the Voyager net, Newton. Koppel on the near boards, get a bounce. And Ashwaubenon keeps it in. Shot blocked out front by Foth. That gets dumped back in deep. Markison on the defense. That gets chipped up into the net. Tanner Newton tried to knock it off the boards. 10:43 left, and that's a big stop right there. We got caught a little bit right there, Brett.
Yeah, it was good to get the stoppage in play there. Having a little trouble getting it broken out, and start fresh, get some line changes here, and see what we can do.
Not sure if the officials were wondering if there was a delay of game penalty for putting it into the net or not, but
I think that's just a...
That's an NHL just, thing.
Yeah, just a little hike trying to go
Bart off Trmavich the on the chase. Ashwaubenon will win the race. Burkholz. Ashwaubenon chips it up. Geminani will put it back in deep. Ashwaubenon back to pick it up one more time. Sends it off the near boards, out to center ice. Ashwaubenon will pick it right back up. Nice job by Burkholz. Chipping, getting that, gloving that, and keeping it out at center ice. Vandalis in the near boards. Ashwaubenon comes away with it. Geminani with a big poke check to keep that rush from going. Ashwaubenon down back behind. Centering pass. Just misses. Butchermovich will pick it up. He'll send it up off the boards out to center ice. Ashwaubenon will come back one more time. Eggers comes away with it. Chip tries to chip it up to Borseth. Can't get it up to him there. And Vandalis will come down. That gets chipped by Roskam, and Roskam will go on the chase. Cooper Ruthio back to pick that up. And Jaguars will come out the near boards. This time that gets sent out. Foth back to pick it up in his own zone. Looking. Sends it up to Borseth. He chips it down. Borseth gets taken down. No call. And the Jaguars are trying to regroup there. Foth takes a player off the play, and the Voyagers will keep it in. That's sent back in deep. The Jaguars will have to try and regroup once again. Bartelt with a shot blocked out front. Grady Koppel, poke check away. Foth picks it up. That's sent back in deep. Comes back out. Foth will chip it back down one more time. But Mercatoris digging. Gets it back in deep again, and the Voyagers putting a little bit of pressure on. No shots here, but they are putting some pressure on and keeping the Jaguars on the ice, and that's a big thing. Koppel comes away with it, shoots it across. Tanner Newton makes a nice job of catching the pass, just couldn't get a shot. Goal! Tanner Newton with a big goal from the top of the circles, and with 8:35 left here in the first, the Voyagers have taken a 1-0 lead on a blast by Tanner Newton. Welcome back, Tanner.
Yeah, it's nice to have Tanner back on the ice after his hiatus, and his worth came through right there, getting that bar down and up over the goalie, giving us a quick 1-0 lead, and jumping out to a good start here tonight. Good saves by Henry already so far, and nice job just keeping pressure on and controlling the puck by the Voyagers.
And bottom line right there was they were having a lot of pressure, no shots, but the pressure was there, Brett. And that kept the Jaguars on the ice. And all of a sudden, they get a little tired. They get a little bit lazy, if you will. And all of a sudden, they come away with it. They come away with a big shot, maybe a little bit of a screen, and the Voyagers take a 1-0 lead. Eggers coming out the near side, tries to dump it in. Can't get it dumped in deep. Eggers, Wagner, and the Jaguars will pick it up. They're trying to keep it out. Tommy Vandalis digs in quickly and knocks that one back in deep. Jaguars come back the other way with Wagner on a nice back check there. And the Voyagers will make a change after sending it in deep. 7:50 left here in the first. The Voyagers leading 1-0 over the Ashwaubenon Jaguars. And they're starting to put a little pressure on and gain a little confidence here. Cross ice pass. And that's going to be the first icing of the game. And as always, Brett, the first icing of every period, I got to do it. That icing's brought to you by River City Ice. If you want your mounds to be blue, get River City Ice.
There you are.
Faceoff coming with 7:38 left in the first period to the glove side of the Ashwaubenon goaltender Lincoln Simons. Bartelt, Borseth, and Roskam on offense, Foth and Geminani on defense. Jaguars trying to break it out the far side. Geminani trying to hold, does, and they'll send it back in deep. Nice job by Geminani keeping it in the zone. That's chipped out. Foth can't hold it. He's on the chase. Foth back to pick it up. Shot, save, big save by Henry Allen. Nice play by the Jaguar picking a stick up right there on Foth and getting a shot off. 7 minutes left. Net comes up. Roskam tries to get it over to Borseth. That gets chipped back in deep. Foth will go back to pick it up again. Roskam gets out to center ice. And Bartelt will pick it up. Just misses Koppel. And that'll be an icing on the Voyagers with 6:46 left here in the first period.
Well, it's still a nice start here to the game, Kurt. More than halfway through the period, and have a nice 1-0 lead on Ashwaubenon. Ashwaubenon came into this game, I believe, 10-3 on the season so far, so they're doing pretty good. They're tied in the FRCC with Notre Dame, and Voyagers are doing a nice job putting it to them right now, keeping the pressure on, and so far, so good.
Wagner coming around. That gets poke checked away. Ashwaubenon will control back behind the Voyager net. Thom can't come away with it. They get it back out to their defense. D to D pass. Shot from the point. Blocked out front and a save by Henry Allen. And he'll cover up. Tanner Newton doing a good job of tying up a player out in front with 6:26 left in the game.
Nice job by Henry there. Traffic in front of him and got a glove on top of that puck and didn't allow it to squirt out where could be trouble. Henry's off to a good start tonight. Got to keep it going here.
Need to find a little bit of offensive pressure. We're up 1-0, but we got to find some offensive pressure here, too.
Yeah, it's
and keep the pucks off of Henry.
More than one
out to their
to
defense. D to D pass. Shot from the point. Blocked. and maybe a save off of Henry Allen. Not sure if that got to him or not. D to D out to Cooper Ruthio again. He'll send it in deep. Shot blocked. Ruthio circling, drops it back in deep. The Voyagers will go back to try and pick it up again. Mercatoris will come away with it on the near boards. He's going to come all the way out of the zone. Gains entry, sends it in deep, and he'll go chase after it. And the Jaguars will bring it out the far side. Burkholz tries to jump it in. Tommy Vandalis has a little bit of a steam shot. Blocker saved by Simons. Sent out. Butramovich picking it up. Thom gets knocked off the puck. Charlie Eggers comes away with it. Eggers looking in the far corner. Centering pass just missed. Vandalis with a shot. Glove save.
Tip opportunity in front there, too, by, AJ? AJ Butramovich right in front of the goalie. Almost had a stick on that to try to redirect it out beyond the goalie's glove. Good pressure. Keep the shots coming.
Voyagers going with Eggers, Butramovich, and Burkholz. Vandalis and Markusson back on defense. Vandalis dumps it back in deep. The Voyagers will chase over to the far corner. Jaguars trying to come away with it. Nice job, Butramovich. And it'll come back out to center. Vandalis will pick it back up, looking over to Markusson. Markusson dumps it. Borseth chips it around one man, can't pick it up again. And the Voyagers will regroup back in their own zone one more time. Bartelt ridden off the play. Borseth on the chase. Chipped up. Vandalis does a nice job of cutting off the pass. That gets poke checked. Nice job by Bartelt. Chips it out and around. Jaguars will pick it up and dump it back in. Vandalis back to pick it up. 4:40 left in the first period. Vandalis chips it out to Roskam. Roskam just sends it back out to center ice, and the Jaguars will have to regroup. Jaguars, big hit, and now we got a penalty coming on number 5, Lucas Bartelt.
Going to be an elbow, I'm going to guess. Going to discuss if it was head contact, it looks like.
And really,
it's just a shorter player is what it was.
Well, that, and he's bent over, and he puts a check on him. I mean, the hands weren't up. There was nothing he could – I mean, the only thing he can do is what, let a guy go down and score on his goalie? I don't know what they're really discussing here. If they do anything crazy, I think you'll see somebody going – berserk on a penalty bench. But the either way, the Voyagers are going to be down a man for the next 2 minutes. I didn't even see what the call was.
I don't think he didn't make the call. He told the scorekeeper, but.
And that will be a 2-minute minor penalty on Lucas Bartelt for head contact. The Voyagers up 4:15 left here in the first period. Playing a man down right now. You got Newton and Kopp on offense, shot wide. Foth and Wagner back on defense. 4 minutes left in the period, 1:30 left, and the penalty and the Voyagers will clear. But it will go up into the net, and thankfully we have somebody coming down to pick that puck up and throw it back in, or I would have had to go down there, Brett, because, you know, none of the fans that we have here are rushing down there. We want to say hi to all the fans that are in attendance here this evening. It's good to have them back in the DePere Ice Arena, even though they're not in the rink area tonight, and hopefully that changes before next weekend.
We do have a lot of, looks like, grandparents and aunts and uncles and people from Florida and the UP and all that stuff with us again tonight, so thank you for tuning in.
Jaguars controlling in the Voyager zone, setting up their power play. Man circling. They'll circle and Cooper Ruthio will exchange. Coming in, close shot. Big save by Henry Allen. Maybe a second save.
Nice
job by Tommy Vandalis keeping the puck out. And Henry Allen will just cover it up. 58 left here in the on the penalty to Lucas Bartelt. 3:25 left in the first period.
I thought I saw the ref going to make the goal signal there. That one, uh, I wasn't sure what was going on, but thankfully Henry did a nice job, and I think Tommy did a nice job there too, getting over to take care of the backside stuff.
Yeah, Tommy kept the initial out. Tommy kept the initial out. Henry picked up the garbage, and that's big. And that, you know, the Voyager defense has done that pretty much all year, and picking up some rebounds that could have been problems as that puck is sent all the way back down the Voyagers, checking it up, going to let the Jaguars set it up back behind their own net and waste some time. Jaguars bring it up the near side of the ice. They will gain entry into the zone. Wagner, big hit, taking a player off the zone, off the puck. Vandalis in the back behind the boards. Schwabenon comes away with it, sends it back out to their defense. D-to-D pass, circle shot from the point, wide. Another shot, wide again. And the Jaguars, with 15 left in the penalty, are putting some pressure on all of a sudden. Shot off the side of the net. Jaguars come away with it. 5 seconds left in the power play for the Jaguars. Out to the point. D-to-D pass. Full strength. Nice job right there by Tanner Newton blocking that shot. Jaguars will put it back behind the net. Vandalis will chip it out to center ice, and we'll get a change for the Voyagers right there of two of the players. Markusson comes on. Borseth comes on. Bartelt out. Now Newton will come out, go and get a change. Borseth, nice pass. They'll dump it in deep on net. Borseth back in to pick it up. Gets around one. Can't get it centered out to Bartelt. Borseth will come away with it on the far boards. Looking. Center pass. Can't quite get a stick on it. It was Bartelt. Foth tries to keep it in. Jaguars come away with it. They'll send it in deep. Markusson back to pick it up. Markusson, nice job swinging around to Borseth. Borseth gets ridden off the play. Jaguars with a centering pass. No one home. Foth chips it around. Foth's got a head of steam. Chips it around again. He gets tripped up. No call. Here come the Jaguars back the other way. Burkholz. Foth takes Ruthio off the puck. Ruthio picks it back up, though. That gets sent back down in deep. Foth will pick it up. Back on the far boards in the far corner. Charlie Eggers comes away with it. Eggers, he gets taken off the puck. Burkholz tries to send it out of the zone. Foth will come out, trying to send it out. 1 minute left in the period. The Voyagers. Shot blocked out front by Markusson. He'll get it out. And he's got a head of steam, two on two, back the other way. Markusson looking, tries the centering pass, couldn't get it across. Shot from the point by Burkholz, just blocked wide. Here comes the Jaguars back the other way with 35 left in the period. Shot wide, Burkholz, Butrymovich in the near boards. Eggers back there. Vandalis with 24 left. Vandalis back behind. That comes out to Butrymovich. Butrymovich has got a chance if they hustle. Eggers drops it in deep. Kapu and Butrymovich come away, go in deep.
Center. Somebody center.
Centering pass. Couldn't quite get the shot off. Five left here. Geminani looking. Centering. Nice job right there by Vandalis. That'll end the period with the Voyagers leading 1-0. Again, once we got past that penalty, kind of went back to the back-and-forth game again, Brett.
Yeah, absolutely. I haven't been disappointed with anything that I've seen so far. These guys are bringing it tonight, and that's good to see them stepping up and taking off tonight at a quick pace, because last week's game, as we talked about, was anything but that from pretty much the whole team, and so we don't need to get into that anymore, but... Tonight, things are looking a heck of a lot better.
Absolutely. As we go into the first intermission, we do have a trivia question for you tonight. Let's go ahead and do it right now, Brett.
All right.
You want to give your cell phone out so I don't have to take a bunch of texts?
Absolutely. It's 920-241-0574.
So that's 920. And now you got nothing on the rest.
You're not paying attention, Kurt. Come on. 920-241-0574.
And here's your trivia question for a six-pack of Pops. In 1980, everyone knows that the United States Olympic hockey team beat the Russian national team in the Olympics by a score of 4-3 in Lake Placid. However, in 1979, the Russian national team beat the NHL All-Star team 6-0. In that game, who was the winning goalie for the Russian national team?
I guess that's called Google. Everybody go to Google and see who can tape it.
Well, now that's cheating, and you shouldn't give them that hint, Brett.
All right.
First person to send that in. I think they should have the correct spelling on that too, Brett, personally.
Well, I don't know the answer, Kurt. So
I got the answer.
That with me.
I got the answer. According to John Koppel, this is the correct answer. So
well,
once again.
We've been through that before where we did not have the correct answer. So hopefully tonight JP is right.
So once again, in 1979, the Russian national team beat the NHL All-Star 6-0. Who was the winning goalie in that game?
Are we going to give any hints on this?
Not yet.
Oh,
we're in the first period,
right,
or the first intermission.
Well, let me give
that
my number again then. If somebody has found that on Google, it's 920-241-0574.
And after one complete from the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin, it's the Ashwaubenon Jaguars nothing and your DePere Voyagers one. We're going to take a break. Leave you with Sounds of the Rink, and we'll be back with you shortly, and we'll come back with either the question again or we'll have a correct answer. So give us a little bit and we'll come back with someone who won when we come back.
I can tell you that the first answer I got was incorrect. I don't believe it was Jimmy the Greek.
Well, I got the answer, we'll figure it out. Once again, from the DePere Ice Arena, after one full period, it's DePere 1, Ashwaubenon nothing, and we're going to leave you with Sounds of the Rink and Johnny Cash. Good evening once again from the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin. For tonight's WIAA varsity matchup between the Ashwaubenon Jaguars and your DePere Voyagers. Going into the second period, the DePere Voyagers are leading the Jaguars by a score. By a score of 1-0. My name is Kurt Foth. Along with me, as always, is Brett Thom. Brett, a good, fast-paced first period right there.
Absolutely. It was nice to get out to a quick start and hold on to the lead through the first period. As we talked about, Ashwaubenon has a 10-3 record on the season. One of the three losses that they do have was against us earlier last month. So hopefully we can do that to them again here tonight.
The DePere Voyagers would like to thank all of their sponsors, including Heartland Pizza, Chicago Street Pub and Grill, The Camera Corner, Ambrosius Studios, Robinson Metal, Pella Windows of Wisconsin. We thank you for your sponsorship. Also, we do have a winner in tonight's trivia question for a six-pack of pops. That goes out to cousin of Tanner Newton, Spencer Newton.
Spencer, guessed correctly, Vladimir Mishkin was the goalie that you were looking for. And Spencer's here visiting from the UP, so I don't know if Spencer's 21. Spencer, you maybe can share that with me, but it doesn't matter.
Or you can just donate it to us, Brett. That's fine, too.
And I told him his uncle wouldn't mind driving up to the UP to deliver his prize. So Steve will drive it to you, Spencer, no matter where you are.
Borders are closed. But a little-known fact, Mishkin was the goaltender in that game. Mishkin was also the goaltender who replaced Tridiak, who is known at the time as the best goaltender in the world. So even though they didn't have their best goaltender, they still beat the NHL All-Stars 6-0. Goes to tell you what the college kids back in the day were able to accomplish against that Russian team.
Yeah, that was quite an achievement as we get started here with the second.
Ashwaubenon gathers. John Koppel coming out with his top line of Newton, Koppel, and Mercatoris on offense, Vandalist, and Markison on defense. Mercatoris picks off the pass over to Koppel, chips it down. Newton on the rush, almost picked it off. Here comes Ashwaubenon back the other way. Ruthio loses an edge.
Wow,
Koppel loses
right
an edge. We got some slippery ice here tonight, folks. Ruthio misses on the pass. Markison sends it back in deep off of Koppel's stick. 16-15 left here in the second period with the Voyagers leading 1-0 over the Jaguars. Foth will pick it up and send it back in deep. Good bounce for the Voyagers. Off the side of the, off the boards. Here comes Ashwaubenon back the other way. Foth with a skate check right there, picking it up. Butchermovich sends it back in deep.
Come on, guys.
No call on a little bit of arm to the head there, but Voyagers have to tag up on the offsides. Eggers. Butchermovich with a shot blocked out front. Eggers will pick it up in the far corner. Burkholz will come away with it. Tries to get it out to Foth, can't. Charlie Eggers fighting in the near corner. He'll come away with it. He gets it out to Foth. Foth looking quickly over to Geminani. Geminani will dump it back in deep. Eggers on the chase. That'll come back out to Foth. He'll dump it all the way back into the near corner. Butchermovich comes away with it initially. And here come the Jaguars back the other way. That gets sent down. No icing on that.
Should be.
Geminani sends it out to Borseth quickly over to Butchermovich. He can't get it out of the Voyager zone, but the Jaguars will put it up into their own bench.
Well, you said earlier tonight, Kurt, that you wouldn't complain about the refs, so I'll take over for you. I think they missed two head contacts on that last shift. In addition, that dump in there was behind the red line.
I think they heard me from the early one where I was surprised that they called it an icing. Face off to the stick side of the junior goaltender for the DePere. Roskam, Borseth, Bartelt on offense, Thom, and Wagner on defense. Roskam will get it out, no offsides call. And the Jaguars will dump it back in. Borseth gets it taken off the play. Shot blocked by Borseth. Wagner back to pick it up, over to Thom, up quickly to Borseth. Tries to chip it to Bartelt. Jaguars will control in the Voyager zone. Centering pass. Bartelt chips it up into the Jaguars bench. And if you're going to do that, you got to just send that a little harder. 14-16 left here.
For anybody from Ashwaubenon listening,
we're biased.
Yes, we don't care.
We're biased. Sorry, folks. 14-16 left here in the second period. Voyagers leading the Jaguars by a score of 1-0. In the top line for the Voyagers, back on the ice. Jaguars control, shot wide. They'll gain control back near the blue line. Koppel will come away with it. Koppel gets it out quickly. Mercatoris on the chase. No icing is waved off. Mercatoris can't come away with it. Newton will. Centering pass.
Ooh, Jack.
Just missed Mercatoris. Markeson with a shot block.
Yeah! Yeah!
Redirect by Tanner Newton. And the Voyagers have taken a 2-0 lead. Once again, welcome back, Tanner Newton, with your second of the night.
That was a hell of a play there, Kurt. That was a very nice shot from the point and an unbelievable stick to put that thing back down on the ice, 5-hole through the goalie's legs. He had no chance.
And you're right. There was no chance for the goalie there. That's a heck of a hand-eye coordination right there by Tanner Newton. And that's a big goal right there for the Voyagers to take the lead right there. Now they got to keep the pressure up and keep it moving.
Yeah, good start. So we're almost a couple minutes into, well, more than a couple, 3-4 minutes into this period. So let's keep the pressure on, and here we go, turnover.
Burkholz picks up a turnover. And that's going to get sent all the way back down, and that's our first icing of the second period. And as always, the first icing of the period is brought to you by River City Ice. When you want your mountains to be blue, get River City Ice.
You told me they have some kind of special ice-making machine, Kurt, that makes our ice colder.
The ice is way colder at River City Ice. It's good stuff, let me tell you. It's not just 32-degree ice, I'm telling you that, Brett.
And it's not out of the Fox River either.
That part I don't know. Jaguars come away with it. Geminani, nice poke check to get it around one. Eggers comes away with it. Eggers down the near side looking. Shot into the breadbasket of Lincoln Simons. And 13:26 left here in the second period. And the Voyagers leading 2-0. Faceoff coming to the stick side of the Ashwaubenon goaltender.
It's amazing what 1 week will do. Looking at the way a team comes out and hits the ice here tonight, Kurt, from 1 week to the next, it's night and day right now.
Absolutely, and part of that, nice poke check by Foth right there to keep the rush off of his junior goaltender. Bartelt chips it out, Borseth on the chase. Borseth can't quite get there, win the race. Ashwaubenon will pick it up, and they'll go up the far side. That gets dumped back in deep. Foth back to pick it up. Foth quickly up nicely to Bartelt with a breakout up the middle. And they're going to call icing on that one. And with 12:53, there'll be a faceoff to the glove side of the Voyager netminder.
The linesman on that one is my neighbor, Scott, so I'm not going to be too critical. But if he would have gotten out of the way, Lucas could have got by him, and that would not have been icing.
Well, I would definitely get on him over a beer in the summer, this coming summer, Brett.
All right.
Face-off coming once again to the glove side of the junior netminder for the Voyagers, Henry Allen. Face-off controlled initially by the Jaguars. Henry Allen, nice job covering up right there.
Very good job. Drew tried to play that puck to the side and completely whiffed, and Henry just got out and got on top of it.
Once again, we'd like to welcome back a lot of fans of the varsity team parents of the varsity team back to the DePere Ice Arena. And if we get a stoppage down in that area, we'll see if we can get a few waves and a picture of them up in the lobby. Jaguars controlling. Nice job by Daniel Wagner getting it out of the zone. Eggers, Thom, and Thompson on offense. Blocked initially by Thom. That gets sent back in deep. Wagner picks it up, sends it back up the far boards. Jaguars pick it up. Nice poke check there by Eggers, but he can't get it out of the zone. Jaguars control. Send back in deep. Charlie Eggers will pick it up. Makes a nice move to get around one. Gets it up to Thom. Just miss on that, and we'll have an offsides coming on to the Jaguars. With 12 minutes exactly left here in this second period, and the Voyagers leading 2-0.
And our cameraman's getting a little bit of a view of the parents in the lobby there.
We'll see if we can get anyone to wave, and anybody up there, you never know. Hey, and there they are waving. Glad to see you here, folks.
We don't need to get into our whole political COVID discussion about why they're not in here in the ring.
Yeah, we were there last game, so. Koppel will dump that in deep. Mercatoris on the chase. Comes out. Koppel poke check away. And that's the Jaguars finally do get that out.
Offsides.
Vandalist will pick it up and send it back, and the Voyagers will regroup in their own end. Markison sends it up. Icing waved off since the Jaguar defenseman didn't go hard after that, and the Jaguars will come up the far side. Vandalist with a poke check puts it up into the Voyager bench. No harm done, and we'll have a face-off just outside the Voyager offensive zone with 11:21 left here in the second period.
Good job stepping up by Tommy there, not allowing the Voyager, the Jaguar player to skate around with that puck. Just step into it and chip it back. Don't give him the opportunity to go by.
Voyagers, the Schwabenon controlling. Vandalist will go back to pick this one up in the near far corner. And Schwabenon may come away with it. Eggers is in there digging, though. And when Eggers gets in there digging, that usually means the Voyagers are going to come away with it. And the Jaguars doing a nice job and do come away with it this time. I should quit talking about Charlie like that.
Charlie usually takes care of business, so that's all right.
And you might be able to hear Coach Koppel asking one of his defensive players to help. Eggers gets taken off the play. Jaguars will come back away with it. They send it back in deep, and Vandalist back to pick it up. Looks, chips over to Burkholz. Burkholz up to Eggers quickly. Eggers gets taken off the play. Burkholz will hang on to it at the blue line, sends it back down. Icing waved off. Voyagers are going to get a few men changed here. And here come back Jaguars back the other way on the near boards. Sent across to the far side. They'll send it in deep, and they're going to change. That took a bad bounce off the boards right out in front of Allen. Foth picks it up, though no harm done. Borseth chips it out to center ice. That gets sent all the way back down in. And Geminani will come away with it. Geminani up to Borseth. Borseth's got a head of steam coming out.
Let's go, Kale.
He'll gain entry. Shot on goal. Nice job by Borseth sticking with it. He's down in the near corner. Bartelt chips it back around. Roskam's going to go down after it in the far corner. Comes back around. Foth pinches it in and gets it back in deep. The Jaguars come around with it. Borseth will send it all the way back around to the other side. Roskam comes away with that one. Shots off the side of the net. Schwabenon will come away with 9:20 left here. Nice poke check right there by Foth on a bouncing puck. And we got an offside coming, I believe, on a Schwabenon right now. And I don't think the Schwabenon player thinks he was offsides, but either way, with 9:14 left here in the second period, we're going to have a faceoff just outside the Schwabenon defensive zone.
I believe that was Cole Altergott on that play. Grady and Cole were having a few words there. They play together. quite a bit, I believe, on Bobcats' team.
Puck goes all the way back into the far corner of the Voyager defensive zone. Thom digging. That comes back around behind the Voyager net. Wagner takes a player off. One. Koppel digging. Thom picks it up, looking, tries to get it up to Mercatoris. Can't. Thom will get it, tries to get it out to Mercatoris again. Mercatoris, nice poke check to get it out of the zone. Koppel on the chase. He gets kind of blocked off of the play there. And the Schwabenon picks it up. Nice job by Drew Thom right there, keeping his feet on the puck. 8:30 left in the second period. D to D pass. And the defenseman for a Schwabenon will send that one up into the rafters. That one might have stayed up in the roof right there.
Yeah, we're going to be talking to all you 85 folks that are watching here tonight. We got a couple projects coming up for the De Pere Voyagers here, coming up in the not-too-distant future, and we'll have some fundraising opportunities that hopefully all of you can participate in as well. Not necessarily refurbishing the rink, but... there's going to be a situation where we may have to purchase our locker rooms.
Nice job by Vandalis, initially keeping that puck in, and they do keep it in momentarily, but here comes the Schwabenon back the other way. Vandalis with a poke check shot, saved by Allen. And Vandalis will go down into the far corner, digging, trying to keep the puck out from out in front. Schwabenon will come away with it back behind the net, and now Barchmovich comes away, gets it up to Thom. I believe that's Thom.
Yep.
He tips it around. Cully Thom does a nice job of forcing the play there. Schwabenon come away with it. Schwabenon coming up center ice, gets it up to this in, gains entry. They'll shoot, shot, blocked. Another shot, that's steered wide by Allen. Not sure if that would have went wide or not. Nice job right there getting it up to Bartelt. Bartelt, one on two. He'll take a shot from center ice on net. That's steered wide into the near corner. He gets ridden off a play. No play on the puck. Foth with a shot. Blocked out front. Geminani. And now we got a one on a breakaway going back the other way. Shot. Save. Nice job by Borseth right there with the back check. Geminani gets it out to center ice, so nothing else hurt there. And we got an offsides coming on a Schwabenon. And right there, it's what the Voyager offense can do to really help out their junior goaltender is really do the back checking, Brett.
Yeah, I think Kale Borseth, obviously he inherited that speed from his father, Coach Borseth. And Kale was able to catch up to that play, get a stick on the shot, and not give Schwabenon a good opportunity to get a shot on goal.
And I guarantee you if we go and talk to Connie Borseth, she's going to say it was her speed.
Well, you might be right.
Coach Koppel coming out with his top line of Mercatoris, Koppel and Newton. Shot! Save. Oh. That comes back out to center ice. It's a two-on-one back the other way. Nice job. We got another offsides on the Jaguars, and they don't like the call. It was close.
Yeah, that's
but they don't like the call
again over there. That was taken off on the play. He made the pass across, and the pass that he made was a little bit backwards to the second forward coming in. I don't know what the holdup or discussion is here, but I guess
I think Tanner and a Schwabenon player were having a chat. Some of these players do play together in the off season with the Green Bay Bobcats, that's a good way to make some friends right there. As Schwabenon will dump it back in deep, Newton back to pick it up. Newton chips it out. Mercatoris gets ridden off the play. Tanner Newton will come away with it, and he takes a shot. Koppel on the chase. That goes sent all the way back down and around, and the Jaguars will gain control in the Voyager zone. Newton rides a player off the play. Koppel can't stop the D-to-D pass. Ruthio, the shot up over the net. Butchermovich, nice job picking it up. And we got a penalty coming on a Schwabenon. We got an interference coming on a Schwabenon, and don't mean to be negative on this one, but in the grand scheme, it's about time, because there was some stuff going on that could have been called earlier than that. Either way, 5:47 left here in the second period, and the Voyagers are going to go on a two-minute, one-man advantage on the penalty to number 11 for a Schwabenon, Zach Westcott. And right now, the Voyagers getting a goal here would be huge, Brett.
Yeah, getting a three-goal lead here, not to have that opportunity to be within one would be very helpful as this period comes to a close. Half of it spent on a power play.
John Koppel coming out with his second line power play here of Bartelt, Butchermavich, and Mercatoris. Mercatoris in the far corner gets it out to Markison, over to Wagner. Wagner will dump it back in deep. Mercatoris picks it up. Back to Bartelt, tries the center. No way that one's getting through. Markison comes away with it. He'll circle out top, sends it back off the boards to Butchermavich. Butchermavich with a nice centering pass, blocked on the shot. Mercatoris' shot. Wagner can't keep that in. And there's a foot race down the opposite way. Mercatoris will win the foot race, and he'll kick it over. Wagner will pick it up.
Wagner
picked it up.
Markison won the foot race.
Well, I know, but Wagner picked it up.
I know, you said Mercatoris.
That was close. It started with an M. Markison sends it up off the boards to Koppel. Koppel will send it in, but Markison will pick it up, and he'll gain entry. Takes a little bit of a shot, and they'll send it all the way down. Wagner back to pick it up. Markison gets a change. Wagner, nice move to get around one man.
All right, let's set this up.
Come back the other way. Folt will pick it up off the board. Sent up quickly to Eggers, and they gain entry. Eggers down back in the near corner. The Voyagers will set it up. Folt grabs it at the top. D to D pass. Vandalist circling. Vandalist down to Koppel. Koppel coming up to the top, and now they got it all set up. Koppel over to Folt. Both over to Vandalist. Just missed on the pass. 5 seconds left on the penalty. 3:45 left in the period. The power play ends. Voyagers keep it in. Koppel does a nice job keeping it in. Eggers doing a nice job digging. And the Schwabenon struggling to get it out of their own zone right at this moment. Nice job by Tommy Vandalist sending it back in deep and not allowing a line change right there. Thom comes out, shoots it back in deep. Koppel on the chase. Nice job by Koppel with a poke check. Schwabenon comes out. Vandalist will pick it up, get across. Don't let him change right there. That's on net. They still can't change. Only one man changes right there. Tries to ice it, can't do it. Thom will send it back in. Roskam picks it up, gets around one man. And right now, they have him trapped right here. Here early in the second period, keep it in. Wagner with a shot, save, and he'll hang on, and that'll get a much-needed change for their Schwabenon. 2:48 left here in the second, with the Voyagers leading 2-0 over the Schwabenon Jaguars.
That was one of those situations where if I was at Schwabenon, I would have been calling for him to ice it. It was getting to the point there where they could not clear it, and the Voyagers are doing a good job putting it back in, and bad things are going to happen when that puck stays in the zone that long. And unfortunately for us, our Schwabenon was able to fight that off.
Schwabenon comes away with it. Geminani picks it up, gets it over to Folt. Folt sends it up off of Butchermavich's stick. Eggers in deep to try and pick that up. Folt will try and hold it in. He takes the player. Nice job by Geminani right there, picking it up. Jaguars come in, stop, come across the middle, shot, glove save, knocked to the side. Jaguars will control in the near corner. They're coming out towards blue line. Geminani digging. I think that's Roskam digging over in Eggers over there, excuse me. Jaguars come away with it, shot way up over the net. And right now the Voyagers need to get the puck out of their zone. Eggers does a nice job, gets it over to Burkholz. Burkholz digging hard. He'll send it in. D deep and he'll chase. Go on it, Sliver. And nice job right there, taking care of the Ashwaubenon player. Burkholz almost comes away with it right there. Here comes Ashwaubenon back the other way.
Go hard, Johnny.
Shot, easy, easy.
Easy safe, for you to say.
Safe shot. It was a little bit tough for Allen to handle. Geminani sends it over to Mercatoris. He'll get it out of the zone. That'll mean Burkholz will make a change. Geminani's going to make a change. Ashwaubenon coming away.
Nice fourth job.
Hustles back to knock it to the corner, and Vandalis comes away with it. That gets chipped out all the way to Newton. Newton chips it up to Kapu. He'll chip it in even deeper. Ridden off the play. And the Ashwaubenon tries to send it out. Markison sends it on net, and that's a glove save, and they'll hang on. 1:03 left here in the second period. Voyagers with a 2-0 lead and a faceoff to the glove side of Lincoln Simons.
I don't recall who put the puck to the side in front of Henry down there, but Cole Altergott had himself set up just waiting on the weak side for a centering pass to come through there. He would have had a very good opportunity. One of our Voyager players was able to get a stick on that one and get it off to the boards.
Markison with a nice play to dig in deep. 1 minute left in the period. Markison with
there.
A shot.
Come on,
steered
man.
Wide. Kapo shot off the board.
In
front.
In. Oh.
Digging. And Simons gloves it. Almost the third goal. 44.7 left here in the second period. And the Voyagers trying to extend the lead here in the last minute of play.
Tanner put that one off the crossbar. Bad angle off the crossbar. Came down laying in the blue paint there in front of the goalie. Opportunity, but Ashwaubenon did a good job getting on top of that one.
Eggers, Newton, and Kapo on the offense for this last 45 seconds. Markison and Vandalis back on defense. 35 left. Kapo comes away with a centering pass. Comes out, and Ashwaubenon able to chip it out. Here comes Markison. Eggers chips it back in deep. Ruthio back to pick it up. Markison, nice job keeping that puck in. Eggers comes away with it. He comes out to the near corner, 15 left. Back out to Markison. Markison back to Newton. Newton all the way across to Vandalis. Vandalis in front. Scores! Charlie Eggers with his goal. 6.9 left, and that's a killer right there. The Voyagers have taken a 3-0 lead. That's going to go Eggers from Vandalis and Newton and the Voyagers extending the lead, and that's a killer right there when you get a goal that late in a period.
That was a very good vision by Tommy Vandalis there when that puck came out to him. The Ashwaubenon Jaguars were dropping down, putting the body on the ice, trying to block a shot. Everybody assumed Tommy was going to take the shot. I was hoping he was going to put it up over these guys, and he found Charlie wide open, who stuffed it in.
Wagner with a shot wide, and that's going to end the second period with the Voyagers leading 3-0. And that was a huge goal right at the end of the second period right there, Brett.
Yeah, those goals with under 10 seconds remaining in a period are just absolute killers, and especially to get the three-goal lead where they can't get back in this game just immediately with some fluky goal. That was a huge opportunity for us to come out in the third period and put this game away.
Absolutely. As we go into the second intermission, we're going to take a quick break. But again, from the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin, for tonight's WIAA varsity matchup, my name is Kurt Foth. Along with me is Brett Thom. We're going to take a quick break, leave you with Pat Benatar tonight, with the Voyagers leading the Ashwaubenon Jaguars by a score of 3-0. Welcome once again to the DePere Ice Arena in downtown DePere, Wisconsin. For tonight's third period of the WIAA varsity matchup between the Ashwaubenon Jaguars and your DePere Voyagers.
Yeah, got the start we needed in those last two periods, Kurt, tonight. And hopefully the boys keep the pressure on for this last period. Don't give Ashwaubenon any opportunities to get into this game. Keeping them where they're at right now will be huge. And Ashwaubenon got a little bit of a talking to during the second period. Didn't sound necessarily real motivational. It was more like, let's get going. So hopefully Ashwaubenon's players didn't listen to their coach too closely, because he was ready for things to change a little bit.
Going into the third period, the Voyagers leading Ashwaubenon by a score of 3-0. Alongside me is Brett Thom, best color man in WIAA hockey. And you know, it's kind of funny that I can say that, Brett, because last year about this time,
because I'm the only color,
you were
man.
The only, well, you're the only color man here with here with me, but last year about this time, the only thing you would do was I'd say something, what do you think, Brett? And you'd say, you're right, Kurt.
Yeah, well.
Which I am, but
yeah,
that's a different story.
Didn't have a lot to add last year. This year I'm a little more comfortable in the role. But within another month, hockey in my life will be over. So,
except for doing color for the DePere Voyagers. I'm not breaking in somebody new next year, Brett. That ain't going to happen. Almost ready here for the face-off of the third period. Once again from the DePere Ice Arena, my name's Kurt Folt. Alongside me is Brett Thom. DePere Voyagers leading the Ashwaubenon Jaguars 3-0, and here we go.
I think we might have a few pucks skated over during the beginning of this period. There's a lot of puddles out there yet.
Shot, a wide shot.
Whoa,
blocked initially.
There. Hurry up.
Blocked again by Allen. Nice job, center on the boards, and that'll come out center ice. Got a good bounce off of the far boards. Excuse me. And Ashwaubenon will have to regroup in their own zone. Capo sending it up. Looking for a call there. Markussen chips it out, crossed into the far corner. Vandalis will chip it out to center ice. And right now, the Voyagers need to get their feet moving.
Well, Grady Capo is looking for the interference call coming back up the ice, and I thought I saw the ref momentarily raise his
Vandalis.
Like he was raising his arm, but thought better of it.
Vandalis with a shot from center ice. Charlie Eggers on the chase along with Butchermavich. Eggers and Butchermavich. Burkholz will send it back in deep, up off the net, and I think that's going to come outside of the Ashwaubenon zone. 15:55 left here in the third period.
While we wait for this puck to be dropped, Kurt, we got some grandmas tuning in again tonight. Grandma Carol and Grandma Jan watching from Bellevue, A.J. Butromovich's grandmas. I know Cully and Drew's grandma are watching tonight as well. And I know Danny Wagner's aunt is watching also from, I don't remember if that was New Jersey or Pennsylvania or somewhere.
Puck coming all the way back, icing waved off. Foth back to pick it up, chips it back to Geminani. Should have probably taken that right around the corner. Eggers sends it down. Icing waved off once again. Do want to give a shout out to Paul Capo down in Florida. I don't recall what city he's in, but I do know that he's watching this evening.
Spring something, wasn't it?
Something like that. Shot up over the net. And Butchermavich will send it down the ice. That might be our first icing of the third period. And as always, that icing brought to you by River City Ice. I do want to comment on one thing you said, Brett. Grandma Jan, A.J. Butchermavich's grandma, Voyager alumni, Will Reeby's grandma. You got to be hanging on to the Snickers bar tonight, Grandma Jan. Glad you're watching.
And I heard the story after you shared that with us last time, Kurt, and evidently every time we were winning here or needed a win, you would go buy her a Snickers bar?
No, before the game, if she didn't have one, I'd buy her a Snickers bar because she had to have it, hang on to it. Voyager trying to break it out of their own zone. Thom coming up, chips it up. Bartelt wasn't looking. And Wagner back to pick it up again. He'll come out the near side. Loses it out in front, chips it out. Ruthie will chip it back in deep. 14:30 left here in the third. That comes out. Ruthie out front. Ruthie with a shot blocked by Borseth nicely. He'll come away with it. He'll chip it out to center ice. And the Voyagers will get a much-needed change right here. At least the two of the guys. Ruthie, he gets pushed right to the side. And Wagner will come away with it. Wagner with a head of speed coming up ice. He's got Koppel with him. Can't get around one defenseman. If he would have gotten around, would have had a chance. Voyagers back in their own end. Van List over to Mercatoris. Mercatoris looking, chips it up off the boards. Koppel gets ridden off the play. And the Jaguars will try and break it out the near boards. They'll break it out of the side. Markison, nice job riding the player off. Right out in front, shot wide. And right now, if they could start hitting some, putting it on net, it'd make it a lot tougher for Henry Allen.
Well, I'm happy with where they're shooting. Cole Altergott is, I keep mentioning Cole. He's one of the few numbers that I know from Ashwaubenon, but he's been having a good game. He's getting where he needs to be.
Big stretch pass to Charlie Eggers. Just couldn't handle the pass. Bortramovich comes away with it. He gets taken off the play. Sorry to cut you off there, Brett, but Ashwaubenon's going to come back the other way. They'll send it in deep. Icing waved off on that. Geminani back to pick it up. Back over to Foth. They're going to try and break it out the far side. Up quickly over to Bortramovich. And that's on net. Off the boards. Goaltender Simons will play it off out to the corner. Geminani tried to keep it in. That gets broken up. Eggers loses the puck initially off the boards, near boards. And Charlie will pick it up once again. Burkholz picks it up.
Whoops.
Little miscommunication there. Eggers will gain entry momentarily, and here comes Ashwaubenon back the other way. Big hit by Foth at center ice to take the player off the play. Geminani will send it back out to center ice. Ruthie will dump it back in the far side. Foth will pick it up there, gets it over to Roskam. He loses control, and Bartelt will send it back out to center ice. They'll dump it back in. Geminani will kick it back out to center ice. And right now, the Voyagers, we got a little bit of a break. Bartelt, I thought, actually had it. Borseth can't win the race. Roskam can. He'll dump it back in deep. Voyagers making some line change. Thom will send it back to the far corner, and Borseth tries to keep it in deep there. Comes away with it. Mercatoris with a shot wide. Thom will pick it up on the near boards, tries to drive it in deep, and will drive it in deep. Voyagers will continue to chase. Voyager offense of Koppel, Mercatoris, and Newton out there. Newton with a drive. Just blocked out
turn
front.
Turn around.
Here come the Jaguars back the other way. They'll send it in, and they're going to make a change. Wagner will pick it up
and bring
it out quickly and doesn't get it out. I think he was thinking Koppel was going to stay up on the boards. Shot.
Oof. Henry's
not
there.
That puck was blocked out front, and it was a good thing because Henry Allen was screened right there. I think he would have gained it. Mercatoris can't handle it. Markison over to Van List. Van List up quickly to Koppel.
Nice.
That goes back in deep. Koppel on the chase. 10:50 left here in the third period. Voyagers leading 3-0. Here come the Jaguars back the other way. They'll chip it in deep. Markison back to pick it up. Markison chips it around. Bartramovich will pick it up. He'll send it back right out to the Jaguar defense. The ops comes back the other way. Jaguars will dump it back in deep again. Van List picks it up. Back around to Markison on the far side. 10:30 left here in the third. Poke checked away from Eggers. Shot blocked out front nicely by Vandalist. Eggers back to pick it up. Eggers pass doesn't get where it needs to go. Great pass right there by Burkholz. Burkholz up to Bartramovich. He gets it taken away, but that was a great pass by Burkholz. Another stick poke check right there. Burkholz sends it in deep. He'll go on a chase, but that's going to be an icing right there. And I think Wyatt Burkholz thought he had enough of the red line. 10:01 left here in the third period.
Yeah, and the clock is going to start to become more and more important here, Kurt, as this period rolls along. 3-goal lead for Ashwaubenon to get back into this game. They're going to have to start doing it soon. So we just want this clock to keep running right now and have them run out of time to have that opportunity.
Shot, save. Geminani, nice job knocking it off to the side. Roskam sends it out of the zone. Foth picks it up inside the zone. Voyagers left to try and break it out up to Roskam. Roskam gets around one. Nice job by Bartelt getting back on his feet and sending it out in the zone. Borseth on the chase. Geminani picks it up at their defensive blue line. He can't get it up to the offense, and it's sent back down into the Voyager zone. Foth will pick it up. Comes around, stops, comes away with it, pushes it off to Geminani all the way around to Roskam. Roskam comes away with it, sends it back over to Foth. 9:20 left here in the third period. Foth temporarily loses control of it. Bertelt will come away with it up to Roskam. Roskam chips around one, and he takes a bad bounce, possibly off the referee once again. Shot blocked by Geminani nicely up over the net. Vandlis over in the far corner to pick it up. He'll back away and give way. I think that's to Wagner. Vandlis sends it back over to Geminani, and Wagner puts it out. Shot from the point wide. Vandlis trying to chip it out. Voyagers need to get it out of the zone and get a couple men changed out here. Vandlis will pick it up in the near corner. Schwabenon will keep it in.
This is one of those times, Kurt, where we need an icing, and thank you.
And Tommy obliges right there. Tommy Vandalis, he must have heard you. It's either that or you got that microphone
in
that goes into an earpiece in his headset,
yeah.
And, you know, they listen to us. Face-off, 8:25 left here in the third. Voyagers leading the Ashwaubenon Jaguars 3-0 this third period. The DePere Voyagers would like to thank all of their sponsors, including Heartland Pizza Company, Chicago Street Pub and Grill, and the Camera Corner. That comes
out
to center ice, and they did catch the offsides there. That'll be a faceoff coming outside of the DePere defensive zone.
Once again, that linesman, Scott Goth here, my neighbor. Nice call there, Scott, on the offsides.
Oh, you got that one right?
Yeah, that one was right.
That one was right? All right. Faceoff coming just outside the DePere defensive zone. Puck drop back in deep. And Ashwaubenon wins the race to the puck there. Nice little poke check right there.
Ooh,
shot.
Redirects.
Redirect goal. And there was nothing Henry Allen can do on that one. It was a redirect, and the Jaguars have come back with a goal. 8:05 left here in the third, and the Jaguars have cut the 3-goal lead to 2.
And that one was even a redirect, I think, off a skate leg, Kurt. I don't think the player got a stick on it. Wasn't a kicking motion, and it's not the NHL. We can't review those things. It wasn't like it got kicked in intentionally, but definitely changed directions there in front of Henry.
Well, I'll do a replay on it. Definite kicking, and your linesman
blew
friend
it.
Should have called that one off.
All right.
And it wasn't, folks. That was an absolutely good goal by the Jaguars. Nice redirect. Not sure who redirected that one. Shot on Henry and save right there. Nice big save. Another save by Allen. And right now the Voyagers have got to turn it on here a little bit. Got a little bit of a 3-on-2. Charlie Eggers sends it down deep. Burkholz on the chase. Gets taken off the puck. That's going to come right out to Eggers out in front. He gets around one, shot wide. Geminani over, picks it up, sends it back in deep nicely. Butrimovich gets ridden off the play. Eggers in the near corner. He gets punched in. Foth will come away with it back to Burkholz. They'll send it back in deep. And now the Voyagers putting a little pressure on, and here come the Jaguars back the other way.
Catch him, Charlie.
Jaguars making a change right here, too. Try to stuff pass. Shot blocked out front by Butrimovich nicely, and that's going to be an icing on the Voyagers, which isn't a bad play. 6:59 left here in the game. Voyager's got a little bit of pressure there. They got to keep the pressure up now. They can't keep sitting back and waiting for things to come to them.
You got to bring it here for these next 7 minutes. Don't give Ashwaubenon any opportunity here to start getting a little bit of momentum. Start bringing it back the other way and keep it down in front of their goalie.
Jaguars come away with it. Centering pass goes harmlessly out to their defenseman, Ruthio. Markuson sends it around to Cale Borseth. He'll come away with it initially. And that's in the far corner. Borseth chipping away, comes out to Ruthio. Ruthio with a shot blocked out front nicely. Bartelt comes away with it, gets it out of the zone, chips it over to Borseth. Borseth with a drive, save. That was a really nice shot by Cale Borseth. Used the defenseman screening him. Just a better save by Lincoln Simons.
Yeah, quick little snapshot there, and nice glove by the Ashwaubenon goalie getting it out there and snagging that one out of the air before it could find its way to the back of the strings.
Head coach John Koppel coming out with his top offensive line of Newton, Koppel, and Mercatoris, along with Thom and Wagner on defense. Koppel takes the draw, gets it back behind the Ashwaubenon goal. Ashwaubenon trying to break it out. They'll take it back behind, back up the near boards. Thom will keep it in momentarily. And now the Jaguars get it out to center ice. Wagner will pick it up and send it right back in. And that's a good plan there. That's fine to do that and keep it in the far end. I mean, no harm can be done from back there. Wagner will keep it in, chips it back in. Mercatoris keeps it in. Wagner will send it all the way back around, and Koppel will come down and try and send it back behind the Jaguar net. Jaguars chip it out to center ice. Wagner with a drive, just redirected wide and almost beat the goaltender. Thom sends it back in, and right now this is beautiful the way the Voyagers are keeping it in.
5.5 minutes.
The offensive end.
Go, turn.
Nice stick right there by Thom. He'll chip it back in. And there was a bit of a stretch pass. It was a good thing
Drew
was able to do that. Takes a player down. That's sent down. That's on Henry Allen. He's going to chip it off to the side. Foth will pick it up. He sends it up to Thompson. Thompson chips it, tries to chip it out. Can't. Burkholz can't. That puck never came out of the zone. Butchermovich does send it out now. And the Jaguars will regroup in their own zone. Foth with a nice poke check, gets it up to Thompson. Thompson can't get it past the defenseman. Ruthio, shot blocked out to the side. Geminani comes away with it, send it. Burkholz gets it back to the defense, shot blocked again. Geminani chips it out to their defense once again. They'll chip it back down, shot wide off the pipe.
Get on him, guys, let's go.
Chipped out in front. Bartelt will come away with it. Bartelt chips it over to Thompson. Voyagers
hustle,
trying to
hustle.
Make a change. Shot on net. Nice job. Borseth will come away with it. Chips it out. Roskam's got a head of steam. He can't quite pick up the puck. Get one defenseman change. Vandalis will pick it up. Vandalis going to send it down the ice. We got nice and coming on the Voyagers, and that's all right right there. Had a couple of players that have been out there for quite a while. 3:59 left here in the third period. Voyagers leading this one 3-1. And right now we're going to have to keep an eye. Lincoln Simons is probably going to start heading to the bench here shortly.
Yeah, Tommy's got a good internal clock, just a feel for when things are heading south. Just get the puck hell out of the zone and ice it and save your strength for another day.
We got to get one of those beepers for you.
Oh, sorry.
I've heard worse. Vandalis chips it up and out of the zone. Jaguars will have to regroup. They got an offsides. Nobody saw it, and they was offsides by 3 feet right there. I think that one went up into the bench, and all of a sudden, getting a little bit sloppier. That's sent all the way down. Vandalis will pick it up on the far boards. Vandalis loses it. Eggers over there. Vandalis, Eggers. That gets out to Koppel. Koppel will send it in on net. One man changed. couple of defensemen change out, and right now I think John Koppel, head coach John Koppel, is probably going to do a little bit of shortening of the bench here, potentially. Foth picks it up, chips it nicely over to Eggers. Eggers with a drive. Glove saved.
That was one of those
nice job right
shots.
There. Almost. Nice job by Wagner picking it up. Burkholz will pick that up and send it back out of the zone. Jaguars will have to pick it up. 2:50 left here in the third period. Eggers with a drive up over the net. Butchermovich, unfortunately, Voyager's got a bit of a bad bounce. Wagner will pick it up at center ice over to Foth. Foth's got a lot of room here. If he goes, he does go. Shot! Save! Nice blocker save, but a really nice shot right there by Foth over to Butchermovich. Butchermovich tries to chip it up. That doesn't get where he wants it to go. Foth has got it pinned. Pinned right there. Borseth brings it out. Borseth gets ridden off the play. There. Bartelt trying to chip it out. That gets sent in. Got an offsides coming off. on the Voyagers. Borseth will come out. 2 minutes left here in the third. Voyagers with a 3-1 lead. That's nicely blocked by Foth on the pass. Ruthio comes away, shot blocked up high, and that goes to the far side. 1:50 left here in the third. Voyagers are going to need a change on the defensive end once again. They got Koppel out. That's chipped out. Koppel will chip it all the way down, and that's not a bad thing right there. Would like to have seen it.
Slow icing, too, to take another second or two off the
Would like to have seen him wave that icing off. That's all right, though. 1:35 left here in the third period. We're going to have an empty net for Schwabenon and the Voyagers leading 3-1. And now we got a Schwabenon timeout. And that's a good thing. And right now you'll see, you will see head coach John Koppel really shortening the bench up here and going with his top two lines, top four defensemen.
Yeah, this is no time for everybody to see the ice, unfortunately. Fourth line has been in the game so far tonight, and that's probably all they're going to see, and that's the way it needs to be. I mean, these are games that you're trying to win. You're not this isn't youth hockey anymore where you rotate right down the bench. So it's time to play tough here these last 95 seconds and seal this one.
Absolutely, and it's been a good game for the Voyagers. They've kind of hung on here in the third period, but it hasn't been a bad hang on, really. The one goal that was scored tonight, it was a redirect. Nothing anybody's going to do. It was a good shot, put it in the right place, and the player for Schwabenon, I apologize, folks, I'm not sure who scored that one. But
yeah, I didn't see who shot or who redirected.
And I didn't hear who they called on that one, but the plain and simple, he had his foot in the right direction, and he put it on net. And that's the way that goes, and it's okay.
So once again, with Ashwabadan goalie on the bench here, this is a very important face-off. Win this back to the corner, and looks like Ian Markison's going to be back there. Hopefully Ian can skate it up the weak side and out of the zone.
You got Newton, Eggers, and Koppel on offense.
Get
back
him.
To the
Get
defense. Him. Nice jump. Shot wide. Back out front. Koppel can't get it out of the zone. Eggers can't get it out of the zone.
There we go.
And Schwabenon will take it out of the zone on their own. Koppel, we got a little bit of a break here. Koppel gets around one. Shot just off the pipe, and that would have put the game away right there. 1:10 left here in the third period. Centering pass. Nice job by Newton picking it off and Foth tying it up. That was a shot just wide, and Newton wanted his hat trick. 1:02 left. We got an icing on the Voyagers. Voyagers leading 3-1, and a faceoff coming to the stick side of the junior goaltender for the DePere.
And Grady wanted a pass there. Grady was at the blue line. Like, are you kidding me? Why did you shoot that? I was right here, ready to go.
Because he wanted a hat trick. Little known to him is there's only two people in here right now that have hats on that could throw him out there. Nice job by Vandalis tying that up. Shot
that up.
Wide. It might have been knocked wide. Koppel trying to come away with it. That's going to come to the near side. 50 seconds left. Vanlis lets that go to the far side.
Grady That's, will try.
Grady will go.
Tipped. No
that
icing.
Was tipped off. No icing. 35 left here in the third period.
Stick.
Newton poke checking.
Attaboy,
poke
Tanner.
Checking. That comes all the way back to Vanlis. He'll keep it. Initially, centering pass was knocked away nicely by Vanlis. Folt will send it all the way around the other side. 20 left here. Shot blocked out front. Don't let anything get on your goalie here. Vanlis out all the way to defense.
Nice block.
Shot blocked by Butchramovich. Folt, centering pass. Butchramovich comes away with it. That's going to come up, and the Voyagers are going to win this one by a score of 3-1. Nice job right there by the Voyagers. A really nice game by Henry Allen, and that's a big win right there, Brett, coming off of what happened last Saturday night against Bayport.
Yeah, we can talk more about it now. The Bayport game was a nightmare, to say the least. We didn't play well on offense or defense or in the net, and it showed on the scoreboard. But tonight, the boys came out completely different right from the drop of the puck. Controlled a lot of that first period, Kurt, and never let up really for the majority of this game.
Really was one of the better games that the boys have played this year. And that, you know, they've had some good games. But tonight, I don't know what the shots were. I got a feeling they got outshot tonight, potentially. But when it came down to it, they got the better opportunities overall. Now, Schwabenon had a chance here or there, too. But
And yep. Schwabenon's a good team. I mean, they were 10-3 coming into this game, 10-4 now. And two of those four losses are at the hands of your DePere Voyagers.
Absolutely, and I'm not sure who they got beat by. I'm assuming Notre Dame beat them.
I think 5-3, that was a tight game. I didn't catch the other one either.
If the Voyagers come out, if Henry Allen has a game like he had tonight, that's going to make the Voyagers really tough as it comes down the stretch. This team has a couple of top lines that can do damage to other teams.
Cole Alter got number 11. I think he's probably in the top. He might be top 10, but he's definitely in the top 20 scoring leaders in the state right now. He averages, I think, over 3 points a game. So holding him down and not allowing him to score or have a whole lot of offensive contributions. I was talking about him earlier. He did have a nice game. He just didn't put any points on the board tonight, thankfully.
Once again, right now, I believe we're going to try and bring you the games tomorrow night from Fox Cities. I believe the start time on the JV is 5:30.
It
might be 5 o'clock start time.
5 and 7.
Take a look at Facebook. If you follow the Voyager Facebook page, Wendy Foth will actually make sure that you know that. We're going to try and bring you those games. Not sure what the internet looks like down there. We're going to try a couple of different things. But we're going to try and bring you that 5 o'clock start time for the JV game. Probably a 7 o'clock start time for the varsity game, I'm assuming.
And if it turns out that our feed is not very good tomorrow, when you hop on YouTube, just search for the Fox Cities Stars, and they will be doing a live stream as well, I know. So if ours is not working due to internet inconsistencies, I think they will have a stream that hopefully is watchable, unlike the Bayport live stream last week.
Absolutely. And if we don't bring it tomorrow, we are bringing you games on Monday. There'll be Verone is in town to play the DePere Voyagers here at the DePere Ice Center on Monday. I believe it's a 5 o'clock start for the JV on that evening and a 7 o'clock start for the varsity. It might be a 7:30 start for the varsity.
Yeah, and this is a good game leading up to that because that Verona team is coming off of a championship game last season. So this will be a tough contest Monday night.
Historically a very good team out of the Madison area that's coming up here to play the DePere Voyagers, and that's a good thing for DePere. Once again, from the DePere Ice Arena, my name is Kurt Foth. I'm with Brett Thom. DePere Voyagers take this one over to the Ashwaubenon Jaguars by a score of 3-1. Thanks a lot for joining. Have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow.